Hey guys, Ravi here from Ira Effects. I love making visual effects and animations, and I'll be making tutorials to each video I make. So today we are going to learn how to do this effect. You can call this super speed quicksilver effect or flash effect. And this is a beginner's tutorial considering the fact that you know how to use Adobe After Effects. So let's get started. Let us first divide this tutorial into three steps. Step 1, shooting the scene. Step 2, splitting the shot. And step 3, adding effects. In the first step, all you have to do is add something like this. The character can either walk or run in the scene. In this case, the shot is something similar to this. Once you are done with shooting the scene, in step number 2, drag the scene onto the small icon here to create a new composition. Now go to the point where you want the speed effect to get started and click on Edit, Split Layer. Now select the layer and right click time stretch and set it to 8 so that the video gets speeded up. Trim the composition to the work area and let us see how it looks. It does not look good until the effect is added in step number 3. On the Effects and Presets tab, search for CC Force Motion Blur and drag the effect onto the layer. You can also tweak the values here, but the default settings should be fine. Now, in the similar way, create a new composition with Scene 2 and go to the point where you want the effect to end and click on Edit, Split Layer. Right click on this particular layer and select time stretch and set the value to 8 in the similar way. Let us adjust the layers and trim the composition to the work area. The shot does not look good until the CC Force Motion Blur effect is added. Drag the effect onto the layer. Let us see how it looks. You may now notice that the other character is also being affected by our effect. So in order to cover it up, we bring the original layer onto the top of the footage and mask that particular section of the video so that it gets covered up. You may also notice that there is a girl walking in the background who has been affected with our super speed quicksilver effect. So while shooting the scene, you have to keep a note that there is nothing moving around and everything is stationary. Combine these two scenes into a single composition and pre-compose the scene in order to give finishing touches. Our effect is basically done, but in order to give a final touch, we can add a wiggle effect. Go to the point where the effect gets started and click on P on your keyboard to see the position. Click on this small timer icon here so that a keyframe is created. Also, go to the point where the effect gets ended and click on this icon here so that you create a keyframe. You can enable the wiggle option by clicking on Window on the menu bar. After selecting these two keyframes, you can go to the Wiggle tab and set the frequency somewhere closer to 10 or 12 and magnitude somewhere closer to 5 or 6 depending on your scene. Once you apply it, you can see that the effect is applied between those two keyframes. You can download this project file from my website or from the link in the description. If you are looking for more visual effects and tutorials, consider subscribing to my channel, or you can also follow me on Instagram at VFXGuyRavi. See you next time with another tutorial.